So our today's topic in Python series is tuple, T-U-P-L-E, tuple. So tuple is simply immutable collection of elements in Python, and these elements are obviously ordered. So immutable collection of elements which are ordered, and important point is these elements can be of different data types. First thing is, these elements can be of different data types. So what is immutable means? Means the element cannot be changed. We studied in list that all the elements can be changed, right? We can get any particular element and we can change it. Now, how to create a tuple? So let's see, let's assume fruits is a collection. So suppose fruits is a list of various fruits, we can say so first fruit is suppose mango, guava, banana, apple. So this is how we can create a tuple, right? This is the one way of creating a tuple. We are using this round bracket here. So round bracket of parenthesis open and parenthesis close. Okay, this is how we create tuple. Now we will use a function called type. So what type function will tell us? It will tell us the data type of our variable fruits, right? So you can see that fruits is of class tuple. So fruits is an object of class tuple here, right? So this is one thing. Next topic is accessing tuple elements. How we can access various tuple elements. Now, every tuple element has an index. Every tuple element has an index. In this case, mango is at index of 0. So,
0, 1, 2,
or
series.
Similarly, in this case, the second element, guava, it has an index of 1. Right? So, to access any tuple element, we can simply write the name of tuple variable. Then we can use a square bracket, as we used in the case of list. And we can give the index or position of what we want to print. Now, when you will do this, you can see that we are getting a value of mango here. Second thing, fruits element of 2. Suppose we want to get the second element. So, for that we can write fruits in a square bracket, we can write 2 and we will get banana. Next part comes is changing tuple values. We discussed in our first statement that tuple is immutable, that it cannot be changed. So we will try to change the value and let's see what Python gives us, what issue it tells. So we can do the same thing. You can copy fruits to, suppose we want to change fruits to from banana to something else, let's say cherry. Suppose we want to change banana to cherry. So in that case, what we can do is we can simply change the value by doing this, because in list we were able to change the values. Now you will see an error here. Tuple object does not support int. So we cannot assign a new value to already existing tuple. So in the case of a list where we want our elements not to change, we can always use tuple. We don't want other users to change the value of our tuple, change the value of our list. So yes, you can, in the case of security or whatever reason there may be. So this is the property of tuple. So tuple is immutable, it cannot be changed. Tuple is indexed, so it is immutable and indexed and ordered. So we can see that there is a particular order in tuple, right? And this order will never change. Looping through all values in tuple. Suppose we want to apply a loop and print all the values that are there in a tuple. Here we can see there are 4 values, but suppose we want to print all the values. So for that we will use for loop, or we can use for I in tuple, where I is some index or order or whatever you can say. I is a variable. So for I in fruits, in this case what we'll do is, for I in fruits we will use a semicolon or full colon, sorry, and then hit enter and click write print I. For I in fruits, then right? Now hit enter twice, and what you will get? You will get all the values that are there in a tuple. Right?
I is divided into fruits, whole.
Yeah. So what I will do is, it will enter this tuple, select its first element and save it as I, and we are printing I, so it is giving us first element. Then loop will exist and again enter with the second element. Then loop will again exit and enter with the third element. So loop will keep on printing values until all the values are over. Now here we are getting these 4 values. So this is how we loop through our all tuple values. Now next task is to check whether any element exists in a list or not. Right? Suppose we want to buy these fruits, and we want to check whether we have already bought it or not. Suppose this is a list of already bought foods, right? So we want to check that we have that particular item in our stock or not. So for that we will use a condition. What is condition? If. Okay? So if, and write name of any particular fruit. So let's say if banana in fruits. So if banana in fruits, what is the syntax? If element in tuple, right? And hit enter and we will write print yes, right? So it is giving us an output of yes, because banana is in food. Also we can do it this way, let's say tomato in fruits. We are simply writing tomato in fruits. Enter.
False.
So we can also use if and give our
statement, yes or no,
or we can use the default statement of Python, which is false or true. So Python will give us boolean values and we can change to our value. So this particular step, or these, all these steps, these steps are valid in all Python collections,
whether it is a list, whether it is a tuple or a
set
or a dictionary.
Not in case of dictionary, but some elements are some steps are there in dictionary, but
this is the common way of, you know, kind of inspecting your data collection, right?
Next thing is how we can tell the length of a tuple or how many elements are there in tuple. So to check number of elements in tuple,
right?
First thing, so there is a very simple function called len, and this is valid for all the data collections. So len round bracket, and we can write len fruits,
right?
So len fruits will give us 4 here. So you can see that there are 4 elements in this tuple. Now next thing is deleting any element in tuple. So point here is we use del keyword, D-E-L.
It's like len to get the length, we use del keyword, that is
del, and we can select any particular element. Suppose we want to delete the element at index of 2, right? So this will raise a
error.
This will raise an error. It states that tuple object doesn't support item deletion. Because we cannot change
anything.
But we can do one thing. We can delete the tuple completely. So if we write delete fruits, then it will delete
tuple completely.
Now if we will try to print fruits,
and we will get some error because fruits is already deleted. That's why that it is saying that fruits is not defined. Yeah.
So we deleted the fruit on this line. That's why it is saying fruits is not defined. So these are some basic things that we can do in tuple. And again, a tuple is used for collecting data, for representing any data collection, and we'll use all these methods in our data analysis also. Now another way of creating a tuple is using tuple constructor. So just like list has a constructor, which was called list, tuple has also a constructor that is called tuple, right? Now for this we can suppose we want to represent some data. So we can use the same thing. We can use fruits. Now write tuple,
right?
Suppose we have a list of foods.
We have a list of foods.
So we can copy our list of foods from here. So we are using these square brackets to represent
a list, not a tuple.
But we are using a function called
tuple.
Now again hit enter. And now type. You want to print to what is the type of foods now. So you will see that using this tuple constructor, we were able to change the list into a
tuple. This is conversion of data type also.
Here inside our brackets we have square brackets.
And square brackets represent list. Right.
Next topic in tuples is some methods.
Right.
So first method is counting occurrence of any particular element in tuple. We want to count how many times any particular element appears in a tuple. Right? So suppose again we are using this. So let's write it this way. Now we'll print foods. We'll see that guava is now written 3 times. So first of all, tuples can contain same element at different indexes.
Same element at different positions. Right?
So first construct this tuple. Now we can see, right, x is equal to fruits dot count, and inside count what we can write is banana. We can write what?
Fruits dot count banana. How many banana
is repeated, right? Now let's print x, because we have stored the value, whatever the count is coming, we are storing it in
x variable. Yes.
That's why we are printing it. So it is telling us that banana is appearing 2 times, which is true. Now same thing with we can do is we can count any other element. So fruits dot count guava x,
it is giving us 3.
So that's how we can count for how many times or how many times any particular element appears in a list or a tuple. So this thing is possible with lists also. First,
but if you say numbers,
नहीं आप चेक कर सकते हो उसमें भी आप ठीक है. मेन थिंग इज वेदर वी कैन स्टोर ऑल डिफरेंट एलिमेंट्स इन अ कलेक्शन ऑफ नॉट. सो इन लिस्ट एंड इन टपल वी कैन स्टोर एलिमेंट्स एट डिफरेंट पोजीशन. राइट, बिकॉज वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सम अदर डेटा कलेक्शंस इन विच रेपिटेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इज नॉट पॉसिबल. One element cannot appear twice. Right? There are some other data collections also, like sets. Next thing is to check the position of any particular element. ठीक है, means what is the index of any particular element. So for this we can write same thing, x is equal to fruits dot index guava. What is fruits dot index guava? Means what is the index of guava. So this method will check for the first occurrence of guava and note down its position and print it. Now print x, you get 1. This method has a limitation. It tells only the first occurrence. If there are elements after the first occurrence, it will not be able to tell its value. So this is all about tuple. This is how we can create tuple and we can inspect tuple and do some operations on tuple, right? We can also store numeric values in tuples. We can also store complex numbers and any other data type in tuple. Again, a tuple can contain a tuple itself also. We can create a tuple which has 3 tuples as elements. When we try to print index in a loop, it is giving us 1, 1, 1. Now, so index here is a method. So because list and tuple are both indexed collection of elements, they are both ordered collection of elements. Now suppose we have a tuple called cricket is equal to Sachin Saurabh. So this is one tuple. Another tuple is suppose tennis, and another tuple is Federer Nadal. Now we can create another tuple. So we have created two tuples. One is cricket, one is tennis. And we can create another tuple called sports. And sports is equal to, again we are writing round brackets, and here we are writing cricket, comma tennis. Right? Now if you will print sports, if you will print sports here, then what you will get is, you will get a tuple of tuples, right? So we can do all these alterations, we can do all these mix-ups to create any particular tuple of any particular size. We can use 10 tuples to create one tuple, right? So suppose we have collection of elements in different data sets, different data collections like cricket, tennis, hockey. Or there might be other collections also, and we can kind of collect them together in one particular tuple, and that tuple we can print to get all the elements. Now in sports, if you print 3, we want to get a third element in this sport, so we will get error. Why? Because here there are 2 elements, one is this, one is this. So we have not joined them together. Right? Again, we can suppose we write sports is equal to cricket plus tennis. So sports is equal to cricket plus tennis. Now we will print sports. Now these all the values are joined and saved in one single tuple. Now what we can do is, if in this case we will try to print sports 3, and we will get the third value 0, 1, 2, 3.
Federer is second, Nadal is third,
right? So if you want to create a tuple of tuples and still want to get all the tuples together, we can use this. Now in this case, again coming back to this case, sports is equal to cricket comma tennis, right? Again print sports. So we are back to this particular tuple again. Now let's write sports 0, 0 and 1.
0 and 1. So, Saurav
means the first element of second element of first tuple. So, this is called selector, right? We have two tuples here. One tuple is at index of 0, another tuple is at index of 1. So, we are selecting the tuple at index of 0, right? Now once this tuple is selected, we want to get Saurav. How we can do that? By writing its index here. In a similar way, suppose we want to print Nadal, how we can do that? So correct this sports. So यहाँ 0, 1 लिखा है,
we are getting the concept.
So this is how we can play with different tuples, join them together. If we want to join all the tuples together and put them in one particular collection, that we can do this plus, right?
Or this can be federal data also. यहाँ पे 1, 0
है. So sports 1, 0. Suppose this tuple was also another tuple. So we can select it and we can again go deeper also. So we can use square brackets to go any level of any level, means we can go inside any tuple, then another tuple, then another tuple, right? So this is all with tuples. This is very useful. All these concepts that we are discussing here, these concepts apply to list also. There is only one difference between list and tuple, that list is alterable, changeable, and it is denoted with a square bracket, and tuple is immutable, it cannot be changed. Right? Yeah. And that's why, because list is not mutable, list is mutable. That's why it has many methods like append, pop, delete, right? So this is the concept of tuple. Tomorrow we will discuss about sets. After revision, we will start with sets. So this is everything about tuple. Do practice it. Try different data types. Try using collections of other data types and then use this. Thanks for watching.